actually go and do a virtual offsite with your colleagues. Work policies that can be refined, you know, workflow outlining, who does what, new parental leave policies, what kind of sick leave policies do we need now that people are working from home, you know, things like that. So virtual team building is more effective when it is intentional. There has to be a purpose so that it overcomes the, you know, the cultural and the physical barriers. So in a nutshell, team building activities are really critical to building a stable remote workforce for any kind of business. So when you create a fun and a collaborative environment where transparent communications are encouraged, you can help your team thrive as well as gain business profitability, whether they're working virtually, whether they're working remote.
Were a team while working in office, but till now they are productive, even they are working from home. So you have also identified one a very significant reality, I would say. This is out of 10 workers, 7 are feeling isolated, feeling disconnected. So this is somehow a pressure for their mental health, somehow a pressure on their performance, and also for their physical health. So you have also prescribed few things what a manager can do, what other team members can do for overcoming these sort of isolation feelings or disconnection feelings. So could you please give us a few more light on what employer can do, how employer can change their rules. You already touch upon about the sick leave and other things. So how they can do something more for the employees, those who are feeling disconnected.
Over. Right. So, you know, employee well-being is actually being looked at very, very seriously by every organization. And it is a bird's eye view of the employee's mental and emotional quotient as well as their productivity and the ability to perform their very best. So some well-being programs will also consider the employee's financial health and the strength of their social networks as part of their overall well-being. Studies are showing that high employee well-being can boost satisfaction, teamwork, productivity, and that translates into improving the company's bottom line. Now, how do employers, how do organizations focus on employee well-being? So, see, we touched upon it in, I think, most of our discussions, the flexible work options. So this empowers the employees to alter their work habits so that they can incorporate personal needs and continue to work on their projects on their time. Secondly, no one wants a dead-end job. And employees want progress. What's coming out more and more is that they want a clear career path. They want to know how they can grow in their careers. And they want to know that they want that psychological safety, that they will be relevant after a decade also. So if employers invest in the personal as well as the professional development for the employees, that will definitely ensure a stronger engagement and a stronger loyalty from the employee. Thirdly, you know, working on the employee's individual development plan by taking that a step further. That is a great way to ensure a sense of purpose. That makes the employee feel valued, that, you know, there is somebody looking out for him. Fourthly, a simple well-being initiative is to recognize employees for their efforts and contribution. So many times employers will simply say, okay, thank you, job well done. But to publicly give that recognition is going to make their employee really feel bad. Then they can look at things like, you know, so there is a whole host of list things that an employer can do There are financial benefits that they can do, like pension plans, income protection they can provide, physical health benefits like, you know, life insurance, gym benefits, mental health benefits, mindfulness, meditation, coaching sessions, counseling services, work-life balance benefits, you know, PTO like paid time off, parental leave schemes, sabbaticals. These are fast becoming a trend as well. And very importantly, taking feedback. You know, it's very important that your employees have access to stress management services, which they might value better rather than discounts for well-known restaurants. In other words, to support well-being at work, we need to build and maintain a work culture that makes employees feel safe, a company that feels like their second home. And when well-being programs are well thought of and effectively implemented, definitely you will see lower incidences of employee burnout and higher rates of engagement.
Perfect. You have said that employee wellness, employee welfare, if employer look after that, then they will think more ownership of the company. So employee turnover will be reduced. You have advised the employers to think of employee welfare and also recognize their achievements, offering their more financial security and obviously health security as well. So thank you very much, ma'am. In this new changing world of work, how an employee could ensure his career growth in time? So what he can do to adapt with the new world of work?
This is a very, very valid and a very critical question, which a lot of people are asking. So an employee has to be future ready, you know, and future ready learning is all about developing lifelong skills that can be applied in multiple ways. This is research by McKinsey Global Institute, and they have looked at all kinds of jobs that will be lost as well as new ones that will be created due to automation. So the starting point would be, you know, I would say identify what is likely to not exist in the next 3 to 5 years. How can I as an employee upskill and reskill? And how can I prepare to cope with future tasks? That is very important for me to evaluate and understand and then decide the next course of action. Secondly, I also need to, as an employee, look at imbibing digital dexterity, because we are inching towards a digital economy, which is demanding new ideas, new business models, which are continuously changing. So employees have to consistently refresh their critical thinking skills and adopt digital upskilling to meet those needs. The third point is agility. That is another very crucial skill, because for adopting, employees need to be agile. So having that ability to know what to do even when something is uncertain, the ability to look forward, to anticipate future challenges and be ready for them. Employers will also be looking for candidates who can show that they have the resilience, the initiative to quickly adapt to change as and when it occurs. I will actually take a leaf out of the research that, you know, McKinsey conducted, which is actually summarized in 4 areas as functional skills for employees for the future at work. The first one, of course, being cognitive skills. You know, these include critical thinking, which is like, you know, structured problem solving, logical reasoning, seeking relevant information. Then there is communication skills, which is really, really important, because you're listening, your storytelling, the ability to speak in a public forum, asking good questions, all these are extremely critical. Resilience is another cognitive skill that needs to be developed, which means, again, as we discussed, adopting a very different perspective, creativity, ability to learn ability to adapt, and also planning, you know, which includes your time management, organizational skills, agile thinking, the ability to do a workforce plan, and things like that. The second skill I would say we club under what I call digital fluency. You know, this would include digital learning, collaboration in a digital world, and what is emerging now, digital ethics. Also, software use, by that I don't mean that you need to be a coder. It means data analysis, programming literacy, computational thinking. You know, these are basically how to use systems also. Understanding the digital systems, you know, being data literate. And again, you don't have to be an engineer to do that, but being able to read data.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to your knowledge partner, Developing Bangladesh. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to your knowledge partner.